research is about the glymphatic pathway, which is a brain-wide pathway that works to clean the brain for solutes and waste substances, pretty much like you have in the rest of the body via lymphatic vessels. But in the brain, it's a little different. So this is a principle. You have this big inflow along the big artery, and then you have this movement across the parenchyma, and you have the removal of waste products along the paravenous areas. So this is in short what the glymphatic pathway is in a very high resolution. Well, contrast enhanced MRI is a technique where you actually use a positive or negative contrast agent that you inject to see certain areas or you see certain pathways more clearly. We use the positive contrast agent because it becomes a bright signal on the MRI image, so it's easy to see where things go once you have injected that in a certain area. Basically, what we discovered was with contrast enhanced imaging, what we were able to do was we were able to visualize in three dimension and in real time how this brain-wide pathway actually cleans the brain. And also we were able to quantify it in certain ways, simple kinetic parameters that we need so that we can find out if the pathway works well or if it's slow or if it's, for instance, working in overdrive.
So here we're showing a frame-by-frame snapshot of contrast agent going through paravascular spacing absorbed by the brain. And this is important to understand Glymphatic system.
So this new system that we have discovered and we have captured via this very clinical relevant technique, we hope that it can be used in the future to diagnose patients susceptible, for instance, for developing Alzheimer's disease, or even patients that have undergone repetitive head traumas that may also be at risk for developing Alzheimer's disease.
Well, I think this is very exciting research. It's an exemplar of translational research, which takes a finding emerging from the basic laboratory, in this case, the delineation of the so-called glymphatic brain waste clearance system, and paints a path forward for assessing this system in humans.